Call the city council meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Alderman Caddella.
Here.
Alderman Coe.
Here.
Alderman Lewitton. Alderman Police.
Here.
Alderman Shockey.
Here.
Alderman Eugene Wesley.
Here.
Alderman Rory Wesley.
Here.
Alderman Winger.
Here. Quorum being present, would you stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We have a motion to approve the minutes of August 6, 2009. Is there a second?
Second.
On the question? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Bills, Alderman Winger?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to make a motion to approve a list of bills dated August 20, 2009 for $583,785.80.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question? Alderman Police?
Sorry, I only have one. On page 4, drinking fountain, outdoor drinking water fountain, what's that for?
That's for the purchase of a outdoor drinking water fountain out by the reservoir. The Stormwater Commission recommended that we fund that, and that's the purchase of that.
Okay, thank you.
Anything further? Roll call.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman E. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Caddella?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
That's approved. Do any citizens wish to address the city council this evening? If so, if you go to the podium and give us your name and address, please. I don't see the police chief to check and see if the microphone's on. Brad, would you or Mr. Graff?
We are getting you. I don't know why it's not coming out here.
All right. Would you check if the microphone's on at the stand, one gentleman?
Testing, can we hear?
Good.
Good, thank you. Mr. Mayor, City Council, thank you for letting us come to the podium once again and speak. I was here a month ago and spoke regarding two issues. One.
Before you get too far into it, could you give us the name and address for the record, please?
I'm sorry. My name is Jack McHugh. I live at 288 Windsor Street in Wooddale. Okay, sorry about that.
No problem. Please proceed.
The two issues were the flooding on Windsor Street, which I think everyone is aware of. I understand there's other areas of the city that have the same issues and concerns. That evening when we were there, we were told that there would be a letter written to the county, and I had asked the Alderman of Police for a copy of that. Last week, I understand that a letter was not written, that there was a resolution that had been proposed and passed and forwarded to the county. And my question is, can we get a copy of that resolution? I understand that that resolution was sent to other municipalities, city, villages, or whatever that are being affected, as the term that I heard was along the creek, along Salt Creek. I don't know that our issue has to deal with Salt Creek. Now, maybe overall there is, you know, some impact with Salt Creek on what's going on with the county. Now that this resolution has been prepared, approved, and sent to the county, my question is, what can we expect? What can we anticipate as a positive step to resolve the issues that we have with all of the residents over on Windsor Street? Is this resolution going to go to the county, and then the county board is going to read the resolution or resolutions from the other towns, and, you know, 3 or 4 months go by and they say, you know, we recognize your problem, the city of Wooddale and all of you other cities, but we don't have any resolution or solution for you. What can we as citizens expect from a timetable, a punch list? When can we expect a response back from the county? Do we know what other villages, in fact, are going to send their resolutions to the county? Or do we just stand idly by and wait until September and October come and we once again experience the problems that we're experiencing on Windsor Avenue? So that's a question. I don't know if anyone would like to verbalize an answer to that. Should there be a written answer to that? Mayor, maybe you can help me with this.
Sure. You raised, well, there's two separate issues. One is the regional global issue, which is the Bussey Woods Dam modification. And one is your local problem, Windsor Street, which I'll let the manager address. The DuPage County did not request a letter. They requested that we do a resolution that this is the official position of the city of Wooddale. A letter can be my opinion or an alderman's opinion or the manager, but a resolution is policy of the city of Wooddale. That was their request. The purpose of it is to modify the entry point for the Wooddale Itasca Reservoir to start taking water earlier, mm-hmm. and to change when they open up the Elmhurst Quarry. We're asking the DuPage County to change their rules and regulations so that that gets opened earlier and more stormwater goes into it. Wooddale was the first one to pass it. We then forwarded a copy of that to all the communities. I talked to most of the mayors. Officially, we forwarded it to Elmhurst as well. Elmhurst, Mayor DeCiani is our representative on the DuPage Stormwater Committee. So he now has grabbed the lead on that, and he is now circulating that resolution among the other cities in District 1. It's going to go on the DuPage County Stormwater Agenda. I'm sorry, I don't have a date for you. If you would have called me in advance, I could have had that for you. But the county has budgeted money to restudy the possible use of the Egan Quarry and whether or not they should modify the protocols on the Wooddale Reservoir and on the Elmhurst Quarry. Today, Friends of Salt Creek issued their opinion on the Bussey Woods Reservoir. They have a different approach. They are recommending a modification of the weir, which is the dam at Bussey Woods. They believe the lake level can be lowered at Bussey Woods with a dam modification, and then there'll be additional storage. Of course, anything they store upstream helps Wooddale and all the communities up and down the creek from the problems we had in September. But specifically as to Windsor, Mr. Manager?
Well, actually, there may be some residents here tonight that live on North Cedar, so the status report deals with both at the same time. At the last city council meeting, the council approved two engineering consultant contracts, one for the North Cedar area, one for the Windsor area, to study that those neighborhoods to see what we can do, if anything, to alleviate the flooding problem. We signed those contracts a couple weeks ago. The city engineer tells me that data collection has already started, that we expect the surveyors to get out there sometime next week and start the survey work, and we'll move along with respect to the actual analysis, or I should say the consultants will move along with the actual analysis once we've got the data collection and the surveys done and the grades shot. So that project is underway. If you bear with me just a second, Dave, do you happen to know what the estimated completion date of those two studies are?
For the North Cedar, it's 45 days from their notice to proceed, which was last week, and then for Windsor-Catalpa, it was 90 days from that point. So 45 and 90 days from approximately a week ago.
For completion?
Completion.
Okay. So we ought to have the study completed in 45 to 90 days, and then we can take those analyses back to the City Council along with some cost estimates and see what the council wants to do with respect to what actual physical improvements we can make to those areas to alleviate the problem.
With all due respect, when we were here a month ago, we were told that the contract was either in place or about to be in place and that the funds had been appropriated. And 30 days ago when we were here, we were told that we would have our findings 30 to 45 days from then. So if you're telling me now that we're going to look 30 to 45 days out for Cedar and possibly 90 days for Windsor, and I'm sure it's part of the record, I don't find that acceptable as a citizen. To be told one thing a month ago, and now to get an update that says we could possibly be 90 days out.
Could you clarify for me, just so I can track that down myself, who said that?
It came from the city council. I don't know which particular person made that comment, but that comment was made when we asked, when was the study going to begin? We were told that the monies were appropriated. We were told that 30 to 45 days from then, we would have the results of that study. And obviously, if we're getting this current information, I don't find that, as a citizen, acceptable, particularly since we were here and we addressed the committee or the council, and no one has given us any kind of an update.
Mr. Graff, are you able to respond to that? One of the things Mr. Douthwaite failed to mention is once we get the study back, I think we're going to do a local citizen meeting where we can brief them on the study, perhaps have the engineer present, probably on an evening other than Thursday night here at the City Council Chambers, and we'll send you out a letter so you can be directly involved in it. Mr. Graff?
I guess my only response to that would be it does take time to get these contracts executed, and there is some going back and forth on the language of the scope of work and getting a lot of that ironed out. And I guess I would just ask for everyone's patience in dealing with that. It's not something that can happen automatically. You know, we have standard agreements that have to be worked through is one thing, but also the engineering scope of work, you know, myself going back and forth with their project manager, just takes a certain amount of time to get all that worked out. The contracts have been executed now, the project is underway, and, you know, we look forward to the completion of it.
Anything further?
I understand that an engineer had been out there, and the alderman out there, when I say in our area, I'm not sure what the street is, between Windsor and Potter. And there was some initial findings, there was some initial discussion. And I know that Mr. Pellegrino over here was part of that discussion. And what was communicated was that the gate or the trap, I don't know what the technical term is, I'm certainly not an engineer, but from what I understand, the reason that the reservoir that is behind Potter Street near the railroad, when it only fills up a third of its capacity before the water starts coming back up through the drains and flooding Windsor Avenue. Now, from a layman's perspective, if in fact the information that we had that this trap or this gate or whatever it's called is lower than what the access points are to the reservoir, at some point in time when the reservoir gets one-third full, the trap thinks that the reservoir is full. It's like siphoning water out of gas out of a gas tank or something like that. I don't know how that works, but that's the information that has been communicated to and amongst the residents. So there is some information somewhere that there is some difficulty there. Now, I don't know how, Mr. Graff, we can expedite any of this, but we know that the big rains are coming.
Please direct any comments to myself as
I
chairman.
Will.
Okay. And I think Alderman Police wants to respond to you rather than Mr. Graff.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Actually, I was the alderman out there with John Kramer, and Mr. Pellegrino caught us out there. We were looking it over. Upon looking at the sewers, we found out that those pipes on Windsor are basically half full of water all the time. At the outlet in the pond, there's like a step. So before the water starts exiting out of the pipes, water has to come up and go over, spill over, which I don't know why that is. I'm sure it was some kind of engineering thing or whatever. But I had mentioned it, I believe. I told John, talked to Wally about it. I don't know what happened there, but that I was surprised to know that there's water in those pipes all the time at the end of Windsor and Potter and Catalpeter. Those pipes are half full before it even starts raining. I don't know why, but that's what he's alluding to.
So I would think from just a layman's perspective and some common sense, we know that there are some engineering maladies there before we ever do the study. So my concern is, what can we anticipate with the rain season coming upon us for assistance from the city of Wooddale? Now, I don't know if we can do some brainstorming over this. I'm not sure exactly what can be done. Maybe we can at whatever those intersections are, put pumps, put hoses, because if in fact the reservoir gets a third full, and because of some improper engineering that's in place right now, we can't dissipate the rest of the water through natural flowage, then maybe we need some mechanical assistance to get that water into the reservoir. I'd like the city council to think about that and find out what can be done, because we know come September or October when the rains come, I'm going to have 3 feet of water in my backyard. Mr. Marino is going to have water in his basement. Mr. Gull is going to have problems. The whole area is going to have problems. This is not resolved. So please take that, Mr. Mayor, as a request from the citizens over on Windsor Street to have some kind of a plan in place to give us some assistance when the storms hit in the fall.
Mr. McHugh, would you be willing to serve on a citizens committee with Alderman Police and Alderman Coles and Mr. Graff, Windsor Street Citizens Advisory Board to the City Council?
Absolutely.
Okay, very good. You're appointed.
Not a problem. We'll I don't want the responsibility. I want to be part of a committee.
Sure, understood.
Thank you.
Alderman Shockey?
If I may, there was a stormwater meeting last night, and they are inviting the person who was in charge of the DuPage County stormwater to come to their meeting next week, or next month, on the 16th, I believe, September 16th, and we're asking all the residents to put their questions or comments in writing and deliver them to Dave Graff so that this gentleman will have an advanced knowledge of what we're talking about, as well as any pictures you might have. One other thing I'd like to mention, we've been hitting DuPage County over the head for not doing anything. For the last 3 or 4 years, they have been trying very hard with Cook County to work about that bladder to get something done, and Cook County kept raising the ante and finally got to the point where there's no way that DuPage County could afford to put themselves in a position that Cook County wanted them to be. I wrote a letter to Dick Durbin. You may have seen a copy of it in the Herald, asking him to intercede in our behalf because DuPage County has the second largest number of Democrat voters in the state of Illinois. I understand he did get back to the mayor, and I understand that the comment that came back was that he was not interested in getting involved with our problem. Is that correct, Mr. Mayor? Have I got the words
Thank
incorrect?
You for throwing me in the middle of that political issue, but he thought, I was advised by his staff that that's an issue of dispute between Cook County and DuPage County, and he would not intervene.
Well, I would think, from what I've read about and seen about Dick Durbin in the paper on the TV, if he gets onto a subject, he'll take it all away, whether it's his responsibility or not. And I think if we could get a number of people in Wooddale to write an email or a letter to Dick Durbin asking him to intercede for us, to give us a break, to help the little people, maybe it'll help. I don't know. But we're laying all of this on Wooddale and on DuPage County, and that water is coming from Cook County. The water that we have overflowing in Salt Creek is coming down from Cook County. There's only so much we can do. We're talking about having the level of water in the creek lowered before they open the reservoir. That may happen after next month's meeting of the stormwater, hopefully. We've done everything we can with the bladder. DuPage County paid for the bladder, yet Cook County won't put it in. They don't care about
us. That's a global issue that has to do with the waters that are in Salt Creek. That's one of our concerns. The other concern is the actual issue of dissipating the water in our specific area.
Okay, what I'm saying here is my opinion. It's not
Alderman Shockey, this is citizen comment.
But I have one other. I did mention.
Please proceed.
One last thing. I did mention, and I wish I had thought of it a long time ago. I talked to our manager this evening about the possibility of hiring a contract hydro engineer to take care of the city of Wooddale. Somebody we could have temporarily to come in. And we've got some, you know, we're spending $75,000 on studies right now. And that doesn't include the results. I mean, it's just studies. I think it'd be wise to bring in a contract hydro engineer to look at all of the flooding areas and tell us what we can do as a city. Beyond that, I don't know. Thank you.
Mayor, thank you.
And Mr. McHugh, I advise you that I just appointed Alderman Police with his consent to be chairman of the committee, and with your consent, you'll be vice chairman of the committee. Mr. Graff will advise you when the first meeting date is. Any other citizens wish to address the city council? Got a big crowd out there. There we go.
Steve Critch, 215 Edgebrook Road. I was here roughly 45 days ago, and we talked to the council at that time, and there were some other people here with us at that time. And we live very close to Salt Creek, so I can, you know, tell you that the flooding problems that these people are talking about, we have a little bit more severe. Not only do we have the floodwaters, we have the sewer erupting all over. Some things have come to mind in driving around here, and I don't know if this plays into this flooding or not, or will play into the flooding. And one of the things was, I happened to go down Thorndale Avenue, and they got it down to a single lane, and as I drove over the bridge, I noticed that now Thorndale, the new section, was this high, and I'm down here, and I'm going, what's wrong with this picture? That means that bridge is raised up a couple, 3 feet, so more water can flow under that bridge. I'm going, well, how's this going to help us? The railroad bridge. Understand it was an old wooden bridge. Now it's a metal bridge. The wood was probably bigger. The metal is smaller and stronger. Again, more water to come into Wooddale. Isn't it amazing? I'm looking at how are we going to solve a problem we just opening the floodgates over here. I don't know. I don't understand this stuff. I just look at it and wondering what's going on. Granted, that's Cook County. We're over here in DuPage County. How can we stop this? How can we stop them from flooding us out? We got the Egan Quarry, which is in Cook County. Been flooded since 1972. You drive by there, our creek was almost dry. They could have let that water out, let it go down, and we would have had another place for water to go. Nope. Why can't we raise some of our bridges? What about the bridge over here at Elizabeth? I mean, that's a low bridge. Then we're going to add to that problem. We're going to have a new turn on Irving Park Road once that road is complete, which will come out to Edgebrook Road, which is going to be more concrete and cement. Where's that water going to go? We've got the Thorndale Corridor that's going to be coming on. More concrete, more cement. Where's all that water going to go? When I was here last time, the council says, we'll work on it in 30 days, we'll have some answers. I waited to 45 days. I'm still looking for answers. And, you know, the thing that's frustrating about this is that it just doesn't seem to be getting any better. And like the gentleman said, we're getting into the flood season here, and then it's going to be too late. There's so many issues with this. Who opens a dam? Does it open? Who opens the quarry? All these issues, and nobody seems to have a grip to know what's going on. There is no rule book. If we do flood, who comes out to help us? Where do we get sandbags? Well, now we're starting to get phone calls. After we complain enough, we start to get calls. I think that, you know, the sewage problem, That is, to me, severe. These kids come down there in their bikes and they're playing and they're swimming in this water, not knowing it is sewage. It's nuts. The problem on Cedar and Windsor. Okay, that's clean water, I hope. You know, so we got problems here, and we're looking at, I don't know what we're looking at. Where are we going to spend this money? Do we have an infrastructure problem? Do we have a problem with our sewers that need to be addressed? I don't know. I've only been here a short time. I've been here 15 years, roughly, and it's gotten worse since I've been here. I never got flooded to the last 2, 3, 4 months. So I'm looking for help, guys. I don't know what to say. It's in your hands. You're the alderman. You're supposed to be representing us. And I'd just like to know what's going to happen. What can we do? I understand there's some things going on now that I just heard the mayor say about some things that are happening. That's a start. That's a good thing. But up until then, we weren't going anywhere. We were stuck in slow motion here. Now, I think Wooddale is a good place to live, and I think it's a very friendly place to live. But the more we have these floods and people complain, and all you're doing is pushing the people out. They'll find someplace else to go. That's my story. Thank you.
Thank you, Steve. I can answer or give you a little more information on one of your questions on the Egan Quarry. I referred to them as the Friends of Salt Creek. That's incorrect. The memo was issued by the Friends of the Cook County Forest Preserve. And one of the things they're looking at for the first time I'm aware of that Cook County is looking at is pumping out the Egan Quarry and diverting water from Bussey Woods to Egan Quarry as part of their solution for stormwater. So that's a good start in the right direction. Anyone else wish to address the City Council? Mr. Leitendorf?
George Leitendorf, 216 Edgebrook Road. Just to build a little bit further on what Steve was saying about the sewage. Dave, is there anything, I'm wondering about what they're going to do about when the pumping station at the end of Edgebrook Road starts overflowing again and we get sewage down there. For the last, I'd say last 2 years now, the last two floods, we had so much fecal matter in my yard, just in my yard alone, that my grass is completely gone in one area where it was flooded. So I'm really concerned about the fecal matter that comes down when that pumping station goes out. And you could see it coming over the top of the pumping unit, and it comes out of the ground. And we have the nursery for the children just up the street a little bit. That is something that is really important. And I just want to leave that there. And then just to jump over to what Kenneth said, they're not going to be able to pump out that Egan Quarry until they go ahead and they put some pilings in there and build up the edge of the where Salt Creek meets the quarry. This is not going to be a simple thing to pump this thing out. That's going to cost a lot of money. Back in 1972, when that quarry was empty, and according to Roy Tsai, he used to haul gravel out of that quarry. That quarry was dry. It was not spring fed. And the thing was, in 1972, water was coming into my driveway. It was up maybe about a half an inch. It was getting close to my house. All of a sudden, the water disappeared. The story goes, and I can't find any corroborating evidence to dispute it, that the wall between the quarry and the creek was dynamited. I don't know if that happened or not. But since 1972, there's been water in that quarry. And that quarry is close to 48 feet deep. And I have engineering studies that show that how deep that is. I have a printout, and then I'm going to get that to the next meeting we have. But if the area of the Egan Quarry is equal surface area to what the Wooddale area is, there's enough acre feet of displacement of water in there to match what we have here in Wooddale. But my main concern is the fecal matter coming down. That's the stuff that that's against our health, and that has to be addressed. Thank you.
Thank you, George. I think I can answer your question on that one. The Edgebrook lift station is scheduled for a neck extension. I'm going to have to ask Mr. Graff to explain to us what that is. I presume that's raising the height level of it, and that is scheduled for spring of 2010. I knew as soon as I said that you would ask me that question. I'll pass that on to Mr. Graff, too, if that can be expedited.
It's actually not meaning to pass the buck. It's actually one of Mr. Kramer's projects, but you're correct. The neck extension is to just raise that up, because what happens now in the floods, when it reaches the top of that lift station, the water just pours in and takes the lift station out of service. So that's one measure to help with that. I think the larger problem out there is that whole system, though, being surcharged when we have the severe flooding conditions, and I don't think anyone has a good answer for that. Maybe as part of the future treatment plant work and as part of the bypass pumping at North Plant, that will help lower that. And all of those are going to help out with that. I don't know that anyone's come up with a proposal that's going to guarantee that sewer is never going to surcharge. But I can certainly check on the scheduling of the neck extension and see if, I imagine it's being engineered now and it takes some time to do that, but I'll see if that can be sped up.
It would seem logical to get that done in the fall or the winter before the spring rains would start. Alderman Cadella?
Actually, Mr. Graff, if you wouldn't mind coming back to the microphone. The sanitary sewer problems in the streets that flood, particularly from the creek, you mentioned that a new or a renovated treatment plant that can pump faster and more water can help. But the surcharging that you're talking about, isn't that a combination of, yes, the treatment plant only being able to handle a certain capacity, but the fact that these sewer pipes are below a flood level, so basically they're underneath storm water levels, and they're not entirely sealed systems. Your staff and John Kramer's have a better knowledge of the condition of our sewer pipes in these areas. I know Forest View was lined, 5-6 years ago, something like that. I don't know about Edgebrook and Oakwood, but isn't it also true that a lot of the surcharging could be coming from private properties? You have 50 and 60 year old homes. While the sewer might not have been there 50 years ago, it certainly was 30 or 40. So in theory, we've got some 30 and 40 year old sewer lines coming off of houses that may be compromised, meaning cracks, tree roots, openings of some sort that could also be taking in more storm water into the system, surcharging the system. A quick history lesson, and then